In this tutorial, we will model this part. This will give you a solid understanding of how to model in Shaper 3D. Please follow the instructions to replicate this model in your space. You can pause this video at any time. You can also enlarge it or drag it around if it's in the way. A shape like this seems relatively complex at first, but it is usually made from simpler elements. First, we will model this shape. Then, this other one above it. Adding the bracket arm. Once the main shape is done, we'll add these details around it. In 3D modeling, you typically sketch 2D views of the object first. Then, you turn these sketches into a 3D body. So let's create this sketch first. In the top right, open units. Make sure millimeter is selected. Next, click the magnet icon. Make sure all snapping guides are turned on. Switch to top view on the top right cube, or press Ctrl 4. Now you're in 2D view, it's easier to sketch this way. The sketching grid is now also placed here. As you're zooming, the grid adjusts to the zoom level. To zoom on a trackpad, pinch with two fingers. With a mouse, use the mouse wheel. Zoom out until one grid equals to 5 millimeters. This will make it easier to create this sketch. In units, lock the grid to 5 millimeters so it won't change as you zoom. Move the view slightly to the left. On trackpad, use two fingers. With a mouse, press Shift, then right-click and drag. First, draw a rectangle from the origin to help place the holes on the base. Select Sketch in the side menu. The Line tool is selected by default. Select the Rectangle tool. Open its options and select Center Mode. Draw a 30 mm wide rectangle. Lock its center by clicking the lock badge next to the point. Set the width to 30 mm and the height to 40 mm. Select the whole sketch by double-clicking it. By clicking Make Construction, change the rectangle to a construction sketch. Let's draw the circles for the holes. Draw four circles in the corners. On the right, you can see a list of constraint buttons. Constraints are behavioral rules you can set up between sketches. For example, you can make two lines parallel or two circles concentric. Select all four circles while holding the Shift key. As you select items, the valid constraints get enabled on the right. Click the Equal constraint to make the circles equal. Now select the top right circle and set its diameter to 6 millimeters. Draw another rectangle from the center. This will make the outer edge of the base. Select the two sketches at the bottom. Click the parallel constraint on the right. Let's set the distance between the holes and the base edges. Select the bottom left circle center and the bottom edge while holding the Shift key. Set the distance to 7 millimeters. Do the same with the same center and the left edge. Now get out to 3D view double-click the top right cube. Or, if you prefer shortcuts, press Ctrl 1. As you can see, a closed sketch has a fill color. This indicates that you can turn it into a 3D body. Select the sketch profile and pull it to create a body by 5 millimeters. Now, let's blend the corners. Move the camera around and select all four edges while holding the Shift key. To rotate the camera with a mouse, right-click and drag. On a trackpad, use 2 fingers. You can fillet or chamfer by dragging the arrow. Drag it outwards to fillet them by 7 millimeters. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl 1. Now let's create the column part of the body. To sketch on the top face, hover the plane and press space to zoom in. In the Sketch menu, select the Rectangle tool. Draw a rectangle from the center. Set the width to 10 millimeters. Make the upper and bottom sketches tangent to the edges of the body by selecting the edge and the sketch and clicking Tangent Constraint. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl 1. Zoom out a little. Now select the sketch profile and pull it. Set the height to 50 millimeters. By opening the history sidebar, you can rename any steps. Right-click on the cell and select Rename. Rename the step to Column Extrusion. Close the sidebar. Select this edge. Pull it outwards to blend it by 30 millimeters. To reset the view, press Ctrl 1. Next, we will create this hole in the column. Select this edge. By selecting Offset Edge, create the sketch profile. Move the arrow inwards by 10 millimeters. Hover the face and press space to zoom in. Selecting the original and the offset sketch pairs, set the distance between the lines to 10 millimeters. Set the arcs concentric. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl 1. Select the inner sketch profile. Push it through the body to cut the hole. Turn the camera to see the other side. Drag the arrow onto the face to attach its distance to the face. Click this badge. Here, you can modify the body creation method. Select Subtract. To reset the view, press Ctrl 1. Now, we will create the bracket arm. Hover the top face and press space to zoom in. Zoom out a little. Draw a 50 millimeters line from the center. Set the dimension to 50 millimeters. Make it a construction sketch. Draw a circle from the end of the line. Set its diameter to 20 millimeters. Draw another, bigger circle. Set its diameter to 30 millimeters. Select the rectangle tool. Change it to diagonal mode. Draw a rectangle from the edge. Set the width to 50 millimeters. Now, we created the sketch profile to extrude. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl-1. Select the sketch profiles one by one while holding the Shift key. Drag it down by 10 millimeters. If you single-click on a face, that selects that face only. If you double-click on a face, that selects the full body. As you can see, the bracket is still separate from the base. You can select the base two separately if you double-click it. Let's unite these two bodies. Select both parts, choose Union in the side menu, then click Done. If you now double-click it, the whole united body will get selected. Now we will create the details for the bracket arm. Hover on the front face and press space to zoom in. Select Rectangle and choose Center mode again. Draw a rectangle from the center. Set width to 2 millimeters. Make top and bottom sketch tangent to the edges. Exit sketching by clicking Exit Sketching on the left. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl-1. Select the top and the bottom edges. Fillet them by 5 millimeters. Select the front sketch profile. Push it through the body. Hover on the right face and press space to zoom in. Draw a circle with 4 millimeters diameter. Select the edge and the circle. Click on concentric. Move out of 2D view. Select the sketch profile and push it through the bodies. Select the edge around the hole on both sides. By pulling inwards, chamfer by 0.5 millimeters. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl-1. To finish our model, let's blend some edges. Hide all the sketches by opening items. Hide them one by one and close the panel. First, select the four vertical edges around the bracket. Drive the arrow to fillet them by 3 millimeters. Select this edge and fillet it by 5 millimeters. These two edges above should also get 5 millimeters fillet. To get out to 3D view, press Ctrl-1. To blend the edges around the base, select these two edges. Fillet them all by 1 millimeter. Let's chamfer the holes. Select the top edges of the holes. Chamfer them by 1 millimeter. You don't need to select all edges like this if they make up a continuous chain. Instead, just select these two edges and fillet them by 1 millimeter. Let's blend the remaining edges around the body. Now select these two top edges and fillet them by 1 millimeter too. As you can see, all edges around the body got blended as well. That's it. You've finished this model. Now let's take a look at the history sidebar. You can open the sidebar by clicking History. Insert a breakpoint by right-clicking the second step and selecting Insert Breakpoint. Let's change the base size by clicking on the first step in the sidebar. Change the width of the inner rectangle from 30 to 40 millimeters. Remove the breakpoint. You can suppress any steps by right-clicking the step and clicking Suppress. You can filter for relevant steps by selecting Elements. Select this face. Find the step where you extruded the column and click it. You can change the height by changing the value on the canvas. Let's change it to 60 millimeters. Or you can also change it in the parameter card by clicking on the arrow next to the step. Here, you can find other parameters for the given steps. That's it. Well done.